Jr. to the bottom of the track. Jr. will win this tournament. And the big one happens behind her.
Oh my God.
Austin Dillon into the catch fence. All the crews getting out to that car to assist these drivers. Thumbs going up from all the crew members, and the crowd roars. Look at the catch fence on the front straight. Members pulling Austin Dillon out. He's walking. The damage to the floor of Kevin Harvick. What an incredible sight to see Austin Dillon walking away from that three car that is demolished.
Yeah, the 11 gets kind of stuck in the middle there and comes across the Ford's bumper. As he does, he spins back in, gets the three airborne, and he just gets projected off the other cars right up into the fence.
He went from the bottom of the racetrack over two rows of cars and into that catch fence.
Here we go, you see him on the bottom. The wreck starts in front. He runs in the back of the 24, gets up on the 11. Now he's on top of the 54.5, and now it's just along for the ride. Watch the car stop. Watch the car stop. It gets into those poles, and it goes from, I don't know what, 180, 190 miles an hour, I'm just guessing, to a complete stop. That is unbelievable.
And it looks like a tour. That's 3,500 pounds. That stock car is extremely heavy. You see here, after he's upside down, the two is spinning. Obviously, he's already lost control, makes more contact with the three.
Eleven and the four to get together. Here we are at the start-finish line.
It just pushes the three up into the air enough that it rolls over the top of the car. And then that momentum just continues to move him into the catch fence. Underneath the three. And here was the response from Austin Dillon after he got out, pulled the helmet off. The crowd was roaring at this point in time.
Yeah, this has to be the best sight of the night. You know, this is the scary part of auto racing. When you see a big accident, when you see Austin Dillon get out, what he's removing there is his head and neck restraint. It connects to his helmet to keep his helmet from overextending.